Hello, my name is Martin and this is 3D Printing Iceland. In this video I'm going to review a PLA / PHA filament from ColorFabb, so let's have a look after the intro. So for this review I bought a roll of ColorFabb PLA / PHA filament, and for full disclosure I bought this filament with my own money and was not contacted by ColorFabb in regard of this review, just my honest review on the filament I bought. So this filament comes on a clear spool, it's a nice spool, it's sturdy plastic spool. In a previous video I did about the ColorFabb spools, I complained about there was no labels on the spool itself. I resolved that by just writing the name of the filament on the spool with a permanent marker, so that's an easy workaround even though it doesn't have a label. The spool comes in a 750 gram spool, so that is a nice amount of filament on each spool, and I really like those narrow spool. I can load a lot of them in my printing cabinet without taking too much space. Let's have a look at the models in a close-up view. So the first print I did was a temperature tower, and I set it to start at 210 degrees, and I stopped at 295 degrees, and that was the recommended printing range for this filament, and all temperatures in that range it came out good. Layer strength was excellent. I had to use tools to break this off, so layer adhesion at those temperatures is very good, and I decided to stay with 210 degrees for the remaining prints. I then printed out this string test, and it was a little bit stringy on the default settings with 210 degrees, but I disabled C-hop on the printer profile in the slicer program, and then it came out excellent and almost no stringing. So that was minor setting change that I needed to do. Other than that, I used the default settings, and I will post the settings in the filament directory site and have a link in the video description with my settings, so you can have a look at those. But I was really happy with this temperature and settings, so I carried on printing. The next print I did was the overhang test, and even at 70 degrees it came out absolutely perfect. There was no issues anywhere in this model. It was just as good at 70 as any 60 degrees, and it came out really good. Also the bridging test I did, that came out excellent, and this is probably one of the best bridging tests I've done with a filament test on this model, and there was absolutely no issues and no loose strands on the bridges, so this one came out excellent and had no issues. In this print I was just trying to sand the model a little bit, just to see how difficult it is to sand or easy to sand, and it was quite easy to sand this filament. And also here I was using a knife to cut into the plastic to see how hard or soft it is, and this is not as hard as a normal PLA, and it's easier to sand and easy to cut into, so you can use this if you're going to like do model making and have to fit parts together, and it's easy to adjust for print errors or model issues, so you can get a good finish with this filament without having to sand your hands off. So I think this was a very good test. I then printed out the new tolerance test from Angus at Maker's Muse, and all the items got loose. The 0.15 got loose after I gave it a little bit a push. It was stuck at the beginning, but I just used my thumb to push this out and it got loose, so there was no issues on the other sizes. So this was a very precise print, and the tolerances of the filament is very good because of this was coming out great. And then I printed out my maker coin. That also came out without any issues. The letters that are really small came out pretty good, and at the back the logo was getting a good result, so I was quite happy with this maker coin. It had no issues. I then printed out this rose. This was a model I found that I decided to print out and give my wife, because when I was printing this she had a birthday, and I already had bought her a real rose, but I wanted to print out one as well and give her. And this was a very thin walls, it's like a vase mode print, but it's not a vase mode, but it feels like that, and it's a little bit brittle. I was grabbing it from the build plate and broke it off, but other than that the print came out very good, and there was no issues with the print, and very smooth finish on the side as you can see in the reflections. I then printed out this small vase, and this was printed in a vase mode print, and as you can see there are holes in the print because of the waste mode. It's not capable of doing very sharp corners, but the texture and the print came out excellent and looks very good, and is a nice model. It's a very strong print for a waste mode print, I guess, both because the filament has very good layer adhesion and also the texture on the model contributes to the strength as well. I then printed out the Mermi, the Merx Minion mascot. This model was made by Travis at A Pario Design, and he released this model just a few days ago. The wings are printed out separate and are glued in, but otherwise the model is just one model printed out without supports, and there's a small issue here that might have needed supports because of this overhang, but the surface finish with this filament on the back, like you can see, is very smooth and very consistent. So I was really happy with this print, and this is a great model by Travis. I then had plans to print out the Otis model by Chaos Cortec and the Omnom model by Tessa at Sparky Face 5, and loaded both of those models up in Slicer at the same time. And what happened was the models were both aligned to the center plate of the print, and as the models were similar in size, they came out pretty funny loaded up together. So I decided to print them out as they came on the build plate. So it's quite funny how it came out, but it's a great print nevertheless. And I was joking on Twitter that the Omnom and the Otis had a baby, and this was the result. So let's have a look. So this super cute guy was the result of the two models merging together by accident, and it has 6 feet, but other than that, it came out pretty natural for a funny model like this. The print quality on the model is excellent, and there was no issues with the print. Even though on the model there are very sharp corners or ends at the top, it came out excellent and absolutely no issues. So the print came out very good, and as you can see, it has 6 legs, but other than that, it was a successful baby, even though it was created by accident. But that's sometimes how it is. I also had a dual bot printed out that I had on the table in the beginning of this video, but I dropped it on the floor and accidentally stepped on it when I was moving and broke his legs off, so he's no longer with us. But that print came out excellent nevertheless, and it was no issues on printing that model. It's a kind of a torture test, and that one model was also by Travis at Iparo Design. So my thoughts on this filament by this testing I've done: prints out really easily, and it was very easy to tune in the printer profile. Print quality was good, and there was no issues with any of the prints after I dialed in the temperature and disabled C-hop. The filament is more flexible than a normal PLA, and it's very tough. Layer adhesion is very good at 210 degrees, and it was easy to sand and easy to cut into. So for model making and prop making, it might be a good option. And when I bought this filament, I bought 3 different colors, and I can print out all the things with this filament, I think. And I think for mechanical parts that you're gonna prototype, it is a very good option because you can sand or cut into it to make it fit and do adjustment in the model at a later time. So that's a plus to have a filament that you can easily cut into. So this will be my video on the ColorFabb PLA / PHA filament. I had this filament that is called Traffic Red, but I also have several other colors, and I was quite happy with this filament, and I think you should give it a go. For now, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.